everyone, I'm Radhika Udas. Welcome to Express Computer. Joining me today from the editorial team is Salvi Mittal, senior correspondent at Express Computer. Hi Salvi, how are you doing?
I'm good, Radhika. Thanks for having me.
We have Salvi with us today because our topic of discussion is how can technology help fight climate change? Just earlier this week, Amazon CEO Jeff Bezos took to Instagram to launch his Bezos Earth Fund, which will be granting funds to NGOs, scientists, or anybody that is involved in fighting climate change. He has put in $10 million into this fund and has called out to all small and big organizations to come together and fight this. On the same lines, a while back, Microsoft said that it will be going carbon negative by 2030. By carbon negative, they mean that the company's carbon emissions will be removed from the atmosphere in the stipulated time. You know things are getting serious when world-leading tech giants are also addressing climate change, and 15-year-old Greta Thunberg is screaming at corporations for ruining her childhood. So beginning our discussion today, Salvi, what do you think of Microsoft's plan to go carbon negative by 2030, and do you think it's achievable?
As you mentioned correctly, Radhika, Microsoft has been carbon neutral since 2012, and they've been purchasing renewable energy and carbon offsets. So the world population is also expected to increase from 7 to 10 billion by 2050. So it is the time that we raise the alarm.
Right.
Also, the electricity generation is the key contributor to the climate change. It generates almost 25% of the greenhouse gas emissions. Hence, Microsoft and Amazon are the best example for the world to look at. Even Bill Gates says that we need a energy miracle.
Right. So what you're saying is Microsoft could be a leading example for most private organizations. Which brings me to my second question. How do you think the private sector can contribute to fighting climate change? And could you give us some examples?
Let's start with Google. DeepMind is using deep learning at Google's data center to predict the electricity consumption, and they claim to reduce by 40%. Then there is a Chinese transportation company, Didi, who is actually using machine learning for traffic prediction. Then even in the latest report, McKinsey has highlighted a use of sensors inside the garbage bins to predict the volume of the garbage and then guide the garbage trucks accordingly. Also, there's an example by Schneider, who is using AI models to predict the best of the raw materials and then transport their products globally accordingly.
All right, thanks for those examples. My next question would be, for the private sector to work towards climate change, they would also need the public sector to be on the same page as them. And naturally, coming to speak of the government, the Union Budget of 2020 has allocated some funds in the same regard for climate change, pollution control, and the environment. What do you think about the amount that was allocated?
So talking about the allocation, in the recent budget, the Union Finance Minister has allocated 3,100 crores to the ministry, out of which 460 crores has been allocated to the Pollution Control Board. So, which is very much similar to the last year's budget.
Right.
Also, the minister has shown some kind of encouragement for the states who are already implementing or formulating some kind of air control initiatives. Mm-hmm. So talking about the allocation and the budget, the results will tell us.
Right, of course. So we'll have to wait to find that out. All right. The budget has also been very specific about digital transformation and giving funds for technological innovations. So how do you think technology innovations could help fight climate change?
So with the emerging technologies like artificial intelligence, machine learning, Internet of Things, they have the potential to predict the climate change. So to give a few examples, Banyan Nation, a Hyderabad-based startup, has come up with an IoT solution for this waste management. Then we have Google, who is actually using machine learning for flood predictions, giving out the images of the affected areas to actually alert the people living in the areas.
Coming to my last question, Salvi, January 2020 was recorded as the warmest January on Earth in 141 years by the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. Do you think it is sort of hopeless, or is it too late for private sector to take a step in this direction?
Of course we are late, Radhika, but since now we have access to the best of the technologies, we can obviously delay the process of the climate change.
Right, so what you're saying is that once you know, you need to take that effort. Ending it on the positive note, we wrap up our discussion. Thank you, Salvi, for being with us
today. Thank you so much for having me.
Right. We'll see you next week.
If you like the video, please like, share and comment.
Bye.